Welcome to the SoapUI tutorial session 2. In this tutorial, we'll be starting our first SoapUI project and we'll go through the different aspect of it. Okay, so let's get started. So currently the SoapUI version I'm using 5.2.1. Let me show you how we can create one Soap project. Okay, so for Soap project, the first thing you will need, you need to have your WSDL file. Okay, that stands for Web Service Description Language. So let me show you for the project I'm going to do for link conversions. So if you search in the Google link converter, so we'll get that link converter unit. We'll get that link distance unit converter default. So inside, if you navigate to that, we'll get this the WSDL file schema locations. This is the where our WSDL file has been located. So for every SOAP project, this is the mandatory WSDL file. If I just go to this particular WSDL file, we can see that this is basically showing that this XML file doesn't appear to have any star information accessibility. This document is shown below. Okay, so WSDL file basically XML file. Okay, so you can just directly put the URL while creating the SOAP project, or you can just save it. You can just save it as a XML file. Okay. Just for example, for my case, I have saved it as XML file. So SoapUI project link converter. This is a XML document that I have stored. Okay. While creation of the SoapUI project, you can browse. You can use the already downloaded, and you can browse the same XML file to create. So just first, we need to click on this create a new SoapUI project. Project name I have to give, and then initial WSDL. If you have already downloaded the XML file, you have to provide the XML file where it is located. Just for me, it's located SoapUI files link converter. See, this is the XML file located because I have downloaded this file. If you don't wanna do, you can just put your initial WSDL file. That is what is getting displayed here. Schema locations, this file, you can directly put where the WSDL file located. Project name provide as a whatever the name you want. I'm providing is my name. Relative paths, if you want to store all the relative paths to the project file, okay, just keep that part as of now. If you want to check, you can check, or if you don't want to, just keep it as it. This is clicking on OK, so it will take some time and the project will get created, and one test suite also get created. Oh no, I haven't checked it, the test suite. Yeah, it's giving us an option, the test suite, if you want to create test suite. So if you want to create test suite, you can do. I will create the test suite later manually. Okay, canceling it. So see, for this project length Aditya, that this project I have successfully incorporated. This is the same project I'm using. This is a link converter. The both project are same basically. Okay, the name is different. If you navigate to this project, the same project I'm using. Okay, that is the project. The SDL file is a WSDL file is targeting, and the file path I'm created this project by browsing this particular XML, and this one I just pasted the same WSDL locations where the file has been located, created this. So for that, we can see this project is containing two main SOAP bindings, that link unit SOAP 12. And inside the bindings, inside we can see there is operation listed change length unit. So go to that change length unit SOAP that is binding to this particular URL. That URL, if you go over that, you can see it is binding to webservice.net length unit SOAP. And this is containing the SOAP operations. This is the change length unit operations. Just expand it, we'll get the request. This is a SOAP request. Okay, just click on it. So we will get the SOAP request this way. Here we can see this is my endpoint. Okay, this is the endpoint it's targeting. So if I just click, if I put all the values here, if I just click on the run, so it will target into this particular endpoint and it will fetch the data from this particular endpoint. Okay, and these options add this request to the test case that will come later. If you want to, this is a SOAP request are currently under the SOAP operation and binding. We can create our own test suite and test case, and we can use run our paste. We can run this as a test script, individual test script instead. Okay, so for that we need to check these options. Okay, and this add the current response to mock service. If you want to add this to the mock service I will cover later. You can directly add it. I recreate a default request from the schema. Don't need it. If you want to do, if you want to recreate the default request, you can do. Create an empty SOAP request. I don't want to create an empty SOAP request as of now. Already a SOAP request has been provided. And create a copy. If you want to create a copy, so the same copy of SOAP request will be generated. Okay. The thing is that in this SOAP, this is basically the XML. Okay. So inside that we can see the envelope portions. Just yeah, the envelope portion is targeting some particular URL. This is the web URL targeting. This is a namespace. Okay, this is a namespace is targeting, and the schemas XML SOAP ORG SOAP envelope. This is showing. So envelope defines the beginning and ending of a message. Next thing we are getting the header portions. Okay, inside the header portions. After the header portions. We can see the body. The body containing the, this is the body, it should be containing the actual message, whatever we are gonna send as a request. Okay, SOAP request. Inside that body, we have to parse, we have to provide different set of data, and then we need to click on the run to process the request. Okay, and so there's another thing that has been, that is, it's not showing here. This is SOAP fault. This another tag comes after the body. It's provide the information about errors that occurs while processing the message. Okay, so SOAP fault, it will comes under the after the body process. Okay, and header portion basically used in processing the message. Okay, either at the intermediary point or at the end point. Now just put me some value, like I want to convert length value from 1 inches to centimeters. Click on run. Let me just okay, so for this you can see the response is coming under the SOAP envelope and the SOAP body. I'm requested for 1 inch to centimeter conversions, so 1 inch basically 2.54 centimeter, that is coming as a result under inside this tag change length unit result. Okay, using the namespace is https web service x.net. This is the namespace. This is the default comma XML namespace for SOAP. So, and this is the endpoint I'm basically using. Okay, so for the same thing, I've created a separate project there. So we don't need see, if I navigate to there, I already created a separate project, 2 meters to centimeter. I'm converting that 2 meters is 200 centimeter. So, so this one is for basically how we can incorporate create one SOAP project, and we don't need it as of now because we already created save project before removing. No, because we already have that same project. Okay. So guys, we have seen that how we can incorporate a SOAP project and we can send our response. Now the next biggest thing is that I want to create one test suite and want to add this to some test case. So either you can just click on the project and then you can import test suite or create test suite also. Okay, so new, click on the new test suite. Test suit name, given as a given name as Aditya, my name. Okay, so test suit has been created, and if you want to create test case underscore 001, you can create test case. So inside the test case, now this test case containing 0 steps. Okay, so now I have to add steps. So which step I want to add? HTTP request, REST. This is a SOAP project I'm imported, so I'm creating the SOAP request. So SOAP request for a step. Now it's showing whichever the request, SOAP request you want to use. So for this project, I have only one SOAP request, length unit SOAP. So just check on that length converter, length unit SOAP, change length unit. Okay. This is the SOAP request, the basic schema I'm checking. This is for assessments, not mandatory. Just click on OK. So now See, this is the link. SOAP init under synthesis operation. This request has been successfully integrated to our test case. Okay. Now we can just simply change the link by two. This one. Now you can simply just run, put it as a one and feet 2 inches. You can run your test case this way. Okay. So 1 feet converted to inches, 12 inches. So I have successfully created one test case from this request. Or you can directly do it. Click on the request itself and add it to test case. If you click on that, you will have that options. If you want to create new suit, yeah, new test case. If you want to add it to the existing suit, okay. If I want to create, add it to the existing test suit and in the existing test case, I will be selecting this one. Aditya test case 001. So it will be added as a request 2. Just provide the name, it will be just step 2. Provide the name as a request 02. Okay. So guys, you can see that is the request has been, this is the second step, and now we are seeing that there is total 2 steps inside the test script. First that I have manually prepared, and the second that I have just taken from this request. Okay, just generate this request and add it to the existing test case. So you can do it directly this way. Now go to the test script level. You can see there is 2 steps. Just click on run. The first request is processing, second request, both has been run successfully. So if you see the result, the first SOAP request took the 8690 milliseconds and the second one 5570 milliseconds. Just click on that, you will be able to see the request and response for this message. Okay, this is the request number I have sent for the first SOAP request and the response is got. Properties, the default properties, I haven't used properties, I will cover this later, whatever the properties I have taken. Okay. And things is important, guys, that if you see the SOAP request, we can also see the request is coming with the header portions. Header portions is containing the date where that when it is got processed and the status. Status showing is HTTP 200. 200 means it's okay. We are successfully getting the response. Okay, 200 stands for successful. So we can also validate the header. So the next things comes into the picture, the whatever the response I have got, is it proper or not? We need to check. We need to do some validation, right? So this is called assertions in SoapUI. Okay. So assertions having so many things, property constant, that contents, compliance, script, we can use the JavaScript, Groovy scripting here. Then security assertions we can put. So all these things, assertions, I'll cover in my next tutorial. Thank you for watching, guys. Let me know if you have an issue, and please like and subscribe this video. Okay.